Sharks and Castles. Isaac and Wendy wake up at 6 a.m. They are at a hotel in a small town near the ocean in Oregon and have a lot of driving to do. They want to get to Nevada by the end of the day. It will take over 8 hours, so they want to get an early start. After they take their showers, they pack their clothes into their suitcases and put them into the car. Finally, they get in the car and start down the street. Before leaving town, they stop at a restaurant called Julie's for breakfast. The restaurant is already busy, so they sit at the front counter. "Good morning," says the waitress. "What would you like to order today?"
"I'd like pancakes and orange juice," Isaac says.
"I'd like eggs with mushrooms and tea, please," Wendy says.
"Okay, it will be ready soon," says the waitress.
They are waiting for their food when a woman with a big backpack walks into the restaurant and sits down at the counter next to them. She looks very tired, and the backpack looks heavy. The waitress asks her what she wants to eat, and she orders a plate of eggs and a cup of coffee. Wendy is watching the woman, and the woman sees Wendy looking at her.
"Hello," she says. "My name is Jennifer."
"Hi," Wendy says. "I'm Wendy, and this is my brother Isaac. You look like you've been traveling."
"Yes, I have. I've just returned from a hiking trip in Europe. I have been traveling for 6 months. Now I'm going home to Portland."
6 months, Isaac says. "That's a long time to be hiking. What did you see?"
"Oh, I visited so many places that it would take hours to talk about all of it. I saw a castle in Scotland that was built almost 900 years ago. Then I went cross-country skiing in the mountains of Norway. I took a rowboat down a river in France and saw famous cathedrals. After that, I went to Spain to run with bulls and went snorkeling in the ocean there and saw sharks. Oh yes, I took a tour of Rome, Italy, and saw so many interesting places, like the ancient stadium. But my favorite was Trevi Fountain."
"Where did you stay while you were traveling?" asks Wendy. "In hotels?"
"I stayed in inexpensive hotels, but many times I slept on trains. I traveled to every country in Europe, visited all the best museums, and met so many interesting people. But now I'm really happy to be going home."
Isaac and Wendy's eyes are wide from listening to Jennifer speak. After they finish eating, they say goodbye and get into the car. Isaac is driving, and Wendy is looking out the window. She is very quiet. Isaac is singing to the music on the radio. Wendy isn't speaking at all.
"Are you okay?" he says. "You look sad."
She is watching the tall trees out the window. "Listening to Jennifer talk about her travels made me sad."
"Sad? Why?"
"Because she saw castles and sharks and sculptures on her vacation. Now our vacation looks boring."
"It's not boring. We've seen better things than castles and sharks."
"Like what?"
"Well," says Isaac, thinking of something to say, "we saw a ghost near Pittsburgh."
"That wasn't a ghost, Isaac. It was a white horse," says Wendy, as she looks sadly out the car window again.
"We went to Mount Rushmore. That was fun."
"It was not fun. It was raining and we got lost."
"Yes, but you found the trail with your compass. You were so good."
"Yes, that was good," says Wendy, starting to smile.
"And remember when we went fishing in Montana?" Now she's laughing. "That was not fun. You caught 5 fish and I didn't catch any."
"But they tasted good when you cooked them," says Wendy.
Isaac laughs, and then he and Wendy are quiet again, remembering their long trip together as they drive down the road. After driving about 50 miles, Isaac sees a sign and stops the car.
"What are you doing?" Wendy asks.
"Come with me," Isaac says. They get out of the car and follow a long trail. Soon they are looking down on the Pacific Ocean. They are very high up, and the ocean looks so blue. The water lights up like diamonds as the sun touches it. Birds are flying in the clouds.
"It isn't a castle or a shark," Isaac says, looking at the ocean. "But it's still nice."
"It's more than nice," Wendy says. She is smiling now. "It's beautiful."
After about 5 minutes, she says,
Thank you for stopping here, Isaac. I've been thinking. Next year, we are going to different schools, and we may not see each other very much. Maybe we didn't see castles and sharks on this trip, but we are traveling together. That's more important to me than ancient buildings.
They look down on the ocean one more time, then return to the car. They are happy again, and ready to see what happens next on their road trip.